Hello guys, welcome to our next tutorial video from Science Academy. Today we are here with the second part of the topic cell. In the first part, we have discussed about the history, discovery and the cell theory. Today we will discuss about the basic informations of the structure of cell. So let's begin. So we have already known that cell is very important thing for every living organism. Every living organism is made up of cell. So they are called structural unit of life. As well as every function of the body takes place in the cell or takes place through the cell, so they are also called functional unit of life. So they are the basic living unit of all organism. Cell determines the structure and functions of living organism. They are specialized to perform specific functions. Cells are made up of different cell organelles. So what are cell organelles? So let's see that. Cell organelles are some specialized structures within the cell. They are present in the cell. The cells are made up of cell organelles. Every cell organelles are responsible for specific functions. So here are three functional regions of cell or three functional organelles of a cell. So what are those? At first, plasma membrane. What is plasma membrane? So plasma membrane, it is the outermost thin transparent electron microscopic semi-permeable membrane. It helps in exchange of materials between cytoplasm and extracellular fluid. But in plants, outer to plasma membrane, there is a rigid, non-living, protective and supportive layer called cell wall. Cell wall is not present in the animal cells. The next important thing is cytoplasm. Cytoplasm is a homogeneous colloidal ground substance present between the plasma membrane and nucleus. It is the seat of both biosynthetic and catabolic pathways. So, the biosynthetic and catabolic pathways take place in the cytoplasm. Cytoplasm has a number of cytoplasmic structures which are divided into two categories. Those are called cell organelles and cell inclusions. The next part is nucleus. It contains DNA, which contains chromosomes. It directs and controls all the cellular activities, so it is called director of cell. While its DNA forms the genes which act as units of heredity and variations. On the basis of nature of nucleus, the cells are divided into two categories. These are prokaryotic cells and eukaryotic cells. So let's have an idea of the classification of cell. So based on nucleus, cells are divided into two categories. Which are those? Those are prokaryotic cells and eukaryotic cells, or prokaryotes or eukaryotes. Eukaryotic cells are further divided into single-celled organisms and multicellular organisms. Sorry guys, here is some problem. I am zooming out and you can see here This is single cell and multicellular cell. Okay, eukaryotic cell is further divided into two categories. Then multicellular cell is further divided into plant cell and animal cell. So this is a brief classification of cell. Now, what are the difference between prokaryotes and eukaryotes? On the basis of nucleus, prokaryotes have no membrane bound nucleus or they lack nucleus, but eukaryotic cells have enclosed in nuclear membrane. Their nucleus is enclosed in nuclear membrane, so they contain nucleus. Prokaryotic cells have cell wall and they contain muriatic acid, but eukaryotic cells may contain cell wall or may not contain cell wall. If the cell wall is present, then they do not contain muriatic acid. Now, organelles. Prokaryotes have membrane bounded organelles. Prokaryotes do not have any membrane bounded organelles, but eukaryotic cells have membrane bound organelles. Now, DNA. The DNA of prokaryotes are naked, circular, and usually has no introns, but the eukaryotic cell has DNA which is bound to protein, and they are linear in shape and usually has introns. Okay. Prokaryotic cells reproduce by the process of binary fission, but eukaryotic cell reproduce by the process of mitosis and meiosis. Prokaryotes have single chromosome, which is known as haploid, but eukaryotic cell has chromosome which are paired. Those are called diploid. Now the size range. Prokaryotes are usually smaller. They are 1 to 10 micrometer in size, but eukaryotic cells are comparatively larger than the prokaryotes, and they are 10 to 100 micrometer large. So there are some unknown terms like mitosis, meiosis, binary fission. We will discuss about all the processes in detail in our next videos. So now the last slide, animal cell versus plant cell. So what are the differences between animal and plant cells? So animal cells are usually smaller in size, plant cells are larger in size. No cell wall is present in animal cell, but cell wall is present in plant cell. Nucleus is present in the center in case of animal cells, but in case of plant cell, nucleus is present on the other side. Animal cells have many small vacuoles, but plant cells have only one larger vacuoles. Plasmodesmata is present in case of animal cell, but plasmodesmata is absent in plant cell. Animal cell consists of lysosome, but plant cell lack lysosome. So we will discuss every cell organelles, everything in the next videos in detail. So keep watching.